Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Monday of the 23rd week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. You are just, O Lord, and your judgment is right. Treat your servant in accord with your merciful love.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. Our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, it is widely reported that there is immorality among you, an immorality of a kind not found even among pagans. A man living with his father's wife, and you are inflated with pride. Should you not rather have been sorrowful? The one who did this deed should be expelled from your midst. I, for my part, although absent in body, but present in spirit, have already, as if present, pronounced judgment on the one who has committed this deed, in the name of our Lord Jesus. When you have gathered together, and I am with you in spirit, with the power of the Lord Jesus, you are to deliver this man to Satan for the destruction of his flesh, so that his spirit may be saved on the day of the Lord. Your boasting is not appropriate. Do you not know that a little yeast leavens all the dough? Clear out the old yeast, so that you may become a fresh batch of dough, inasmuch as you are unleavened. For our paschal lamb, Christ, has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us celebrate the feast not with the old yeast, the yeast of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Lead me in your justice, Lord.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
For you, O God, delight not in wickedness. No evil man remains with you. The arrogant may not stand in your sight. You hate all evildoers.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
You destroy all who speak falsehood. The bloodthirsty and the deceitful the Lord abhors.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
But let all who take refuge in you be glad and exult forever. Protect them, that you may be the joy of those who love your name.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. My sheep hear my voice, says the Lord. I know them, and they follow me. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On a certain Sabbath, Jesus went into the synagogue and taught there. And there was a man there whose right hand was withered. The scribes and Pharisees watched him closely to see if he would cure on the Sabbath, so that they might discover a reason to accuse him. But he realized their intentions and said to the man with the withered hand, "Come up and stand before us." And he rose and stood there. Then Jesus said to them, "I ask you, is it lawful to do good on the Sabbath rather than to do evil, to save life rather than to destroy it?" Looking around at them, he then said to him, "Stretch out your hand." He did so, and his hand was restored. But they became enraged and discussed together what they might do to Jesus. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Kung matatandaan natin last Saturday, if you remember, we were talking about how the Lord ended the gospel last Sunday saying that the Son of Man is the Lord of the Sabbath. So here you have now again the issue of the Sabbath, no? And the first point that I'd like you to consider for your reflection is we need to remember that the original issue between Jesus and the religious authorities is precisely, no, the entire issue of the Lord violating the Sabbath. And then the issue of blasphemy came much later. So that's the first point that we'd like to reflect on. And then the second point is that, you know, that very beautiful question of the Lord, no? Is it right to do good or evil on a Sabbath, to save life or to destroy it? And the point that is very interesting for our reflection, what was the response of the religious authorities? Silence. So they were just silent about it. And then the third and final point was the response of Christ to that question. He acted. He saved life. He did good. So that was the response of Christ. That is the third point. So siguro ito yung ating pagnilayan ngayong araw. Pagnilayan natin yung tatlong punto ito na ang original issue laban ng sa Panginoon at yung mga religious authorities ay ang kanyang paglabag sa Sabbath, ano? Tapos yung pangalawang pagninilayan natin ay yung napakagandang tanong ng Panginoon, ano ba ang tama? Gumawa ng mabuti o masama? Magligtas ng buhay o sumira ng buhay? Pero ano ang tugon ng religious authorities? Silence. Tahimik sila, hindi sumagot, no? Tapos yung pangatlong punto ay yung tugon ng Panginoon. Ano yung tugon ng Panginoon? Gumawa siya ng mabuti. Hinilom niya ang kamay ng mama. So the first point is that, you know, when you talk about the issue of the Lord and the Pharisees about the Sabbath, the way I look at it and reflect on it, really, it is a clash of core values. No? That for the Lord, it was what was more important was mercy. Remember what he said in another part of the gospel. It is mercy that I demand, not sacrifice or not ritual offerings. No? And so for the Pharisees, it was more the legalistic element, no, rather than the mission to save people. It was more people following the laws, following the legalistic angle of the law. Siguro yun yung unang punto na pagnilayan natin, na higit na malalim yung pagtutunggali sa Sabbath, no? Kung hindi dito nagtutunggali ang magkaibang core values or pagpapahalaga. Ang pinapahalaga ng Panginoon ay ang tumulong, ang awa, maghilom. Ang pinapahalaga ng religious authorities naman ay yung batas, ano? Yung isasabi nga, being very legalistic, ano? So yung unang punto na yon, dapat natin pagnilayan na kadalasan ang banggaan ay dahil sa core values, no? And then the second point is Christ asking, no? And this is now, he now lays out what was important to him, what was the core value of the Lord. To save life or to destroy life. To do good or to do evil. And here you see now the Lord, or rather the religious authorities, responding in a very malicious way. They kept quiet because they were not concerned about the question of good and over evil or saving life over destroying life. Their main concern was to trap and to put Christ to death. So that was their response, no? And that was a response represented by the silence. So, itong pangalawang punto mahalaga natin pagnilayan. Because, tanungin natin ang ating sarili, pag ganitong mga kailangan na panahon na tayo ay pumili, mabuti o masama, sumagip ng buhay o sumira ng buhay, mananahimik ba tayo? Kasi yan ay isang napakahalagang masasabi nga natin moral imperative, ano? Isang moral na tugon na kailangan nating gawin. So the second point is very, very important. Because really, we ask ourselves, no, in the face of this moral issue of doing good over evil, of saving life over destroying life, do we keep quiet or do we take a stand? Because I think in this case, to keep quiet is to go on the side of evil and go on the side of destroying life. And then the third point that I invite you to reflect on is the response of Christ. What was the response of Christ? He acts. He tells the man, stretch out your hand, and heals the man. So that was the response of Christ. No, it was a response that showed people what was more important to him and why he is the Lord of the Sabbath. Yung pangatlong puntong yun. Sa pagtugon ng Panginoon, ano yung tugon ng Panginoon? Sabi niya doon sa mama, ilabas mo ang kamay mo, stretch out your hand. And hinilom ng Panginoon. Para sa kanya, yun ang kanyang kasagutan. Mas mahalagang gumawa ng mabuti laban sa mga kung ano-anong batas, no? Being legalistic, no? At mas mabuting sumagip ng buhay, no? And siguro may mahalaga din dapat tayong pag-isipan, ano? Na sinasabi ng Panginoon ay isang kabalintuna, isang kasamaan yung pagiging legalistic ng mga religious authorities ng panahon na yon. So today, let us reflect on this. I think it's a very important reflection to make, no? To ask ourselves in our own day-to-day living out of our life. Do we choose to do good over evil? Do we choose to save life over destroying life or allowing it to decay? For me, that is a very important question. And let us pray that we may always be like the Lord on the side of what is merciful, what is compassionate, and doing the good that will overcome the evils of our world. Let us continue our Mass and let us offer now our prayers and petitions. For us Christians, there is no higher law than the gospel command of loving God and neighbor. Let us affirm this belief as we pray for the needs of each member of the church as we say, Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may always be renewed and purified by the words of Christ's gospel, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those in authority may be guided by wisdom when making decisions and setting priorities, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our worship may reflect our sincerity and dedication to the humble service of God and neighbor, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us now offer all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us offer our prayer for our nation. Panginoon ng kasaysayan, sa aming paghahanda para sa 125th anibersaryo ng pagsilang ng aming bansa, sabayan mo po kami sa aming proyekto na magtatag ng 1,000 may tunay na kalayaan para sa lahat. Kalayaang nakaugat sa pagkalinga, hustisya at katotohanan, kalayaan mula sa kahirapan na nag-aalis mula sa nakararami, ng pagkakataong mapabuti ang kanilang buhay. Kalayaan mula sa gutom, kawalan ng tirahan at kakulangan ng dekalidad ng mga simpleng serbisyo sa pangangalaga ng kalusugan at sa edukasyon. Kalayaan mula sa panlilinlang, kasinungalingan at manipulasyon. Kalayaan upang maging mga aktibo at positibong tagapagbuo ng aming bansa. Bigyan mo kami ng katatagan ng loob at inspirasyon na walang humpay na itaguyod ang isang bansang tunay na malaya para sa lahat ng mga Pilipino. Amen. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, to your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord, we ask you to receive us and to be pleased with the sacrifice that we offer you. Lord, wash away my iniquity and cleanse me from my sins. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love we celebrate his death. With living faith we proclaim his resurrection. With unwavering hope we await his return in glory. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with Saint Teresa of Calcutta, and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer our prayer to overcome the pandemic and to rebuild our nation.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come to you to find forgiveness and life. We come to ask for your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. Bless all those who helped see us through the challenges the pandemic brought, those who tirelessly worked to render genuine service, especially to those who suffer the most. Guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission, and to end this pandemic. Heal all who are afflicted. Grant eternal rest to those who died and consolation to their loved ones. As we move forward, grant us the grace to see clearly, choose well, and act right, in order to build a nation closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, faith, hope, compassion, and love. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not deny our petition, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us. And let us pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life, to the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts, that we may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now offer our prayer for peace and joy for our world. Father in heaven, to you we offer this prayer in the words of our Holy Father Pope Francis. We have so much to do and we must do it together. In the darkness of the conflicts we are living through, each of us can become a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. To us Christians, the future has a name, and its name is hope. It is the virtue of the heart that does not lock itself up, does not dwell on the past, and not only survives the present, but is able to see tomorrow. Bless our world, Father, with the peace and joy that the cross and resurrection of your Son, our Lord Jesus, won for us. for all those affected by calamities natural and man-made, for all those who suffer from the structural injustices of our time. Amen. Our Lady, Mother of God, and Mother of the Church,
pray for us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Marami pong salamat. Have a good day ahead and have a good week ahead. Thank you very much.
Dahil sa mataas na antas ng kahirapan sa Pilipinas, malaki ang suliranin sa kakulangan sa sapat na pagkain at kawalan ng sustainableng hanap buhay. Hangad ng Caritas Philippines na matulungan ang iba't ibang sektor sa agrikultura upang mapataas ang produksyon at ani at maibenta ang produkto sa tamang halaga at merkado upang mapaunlad ang bawat pamilya at komunidad. Halina at sama-sama tayong maging bahagi ng pag-aalay para sa kabuhayan ng lahat na nangangailangan at nasa kahirapan. Sapat na pagkain para sa kalusugan ng lahat at mayamang bukas.